Okay, we are ending Callisto Protocol. So, yeah, I assume this is just gonna be the ending, because we already killed the final boss, so... Yeah. Oh. Actually, I wonder if you can actually use this. Oh, this is the same room.
Run!
Oh, it just breaks all the...
Move!
Okay, it just breaks all the... Wow, she's already... I mean, might as well, right? Might as well. How would we die if we... And if we are too slow. Oh, you can't even not run. Oh, you can still sneak. Give me the loot. Give me all the loot. How much? Well, I mean, we are pretty much spent. We are pretty much spent on all our ammo. So... Cool. We do not actually have a timer. We do not actually have a timer. I think hand cannon is my favorite weapon. Well, actually, the skunk gun is the best. But hand cannon is like at all range. You can use it for everything. Oh, you can get up this way, but... I'm... Really? You don't even have a death scene here. That's interesting that you don't actually have a death scene here. I'm surprised that you don't actually have a death scene here. So yeah, this is just the outside hallway that we... Oh, so this is the entire boss arena, so... If you don't pick these up, then the glass is gonna break anyway. So even if you don't pick it up before the boss, you will still have this. Okay, interesting, interesting. When I'm fighting him, I didn't realize that's the outside also. So yeah, I have so much ammo that I didn't even... Danny is like, what the fuck? What the fuck is he waiting for?
Almost there. I see plants.
What is she doing? Oh, you only have one pod. You can squeeze in, right? You can squeeze in though.
I don't know what you're doing!
I didn't. But I do now. I can't keep running from what I've done.
What are you talking about?
I'm sorry. For everything. I do belong here.
Don't do this. Jacob!
Yeah, Jacob survives. How else?
That transfer worked both ways. He learned more about me, and I learned more about him. In the chaos of the moment, I didn't realize he had also given me the evidence I was looking for all along. He sacrificed his life so that I could expose the truth. Was he trying to make up for the pain he caused? Or just chasing some kind of redemption?
He's live.
Either way,
that thing is live.
I hope he found some peace.
Yeah, he's not. He's surviving. Or else, how else would they be able to make a DLC? You know, he survives. Or he won't be able to do the DLC.
Jacob, there might be a way out after all.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. It doesn't work. It's the same thing. It has been three games. How are you supposed to? I do belong here. The protocol. Beat the game on any difficulty.
Say I don't need anyone, but I do. Why is it always me?
Two are better than one. Two head are better than one. Lay down a two head. Beat a maximum security difficulty. The protocol is about life. Okay. There's still four hidden ones, huh? Find all the logs, I guess. One of them is in striking distance. Okay, Grim Reaper, mugshot. Okay, this is gonna be. Copyright music. Okay, let's see about that achievement.
Cause the world outside is going under. You know.
Mugshot. Take a photo using photo mode. Oh, okay.
This life to find another. If there's a universe, even one.
Okay.
Reality,
what else?
Where I'm enough for me.
In striking distance, command.
All of my nightmares are coming true, and I've seen beyond the
uncover the mystery of Carapolis. What?
I've walked in the shadow.
Who is Carapolis?
But how do I run from monsters in the
both secret rooms in the game? Okay.
So I do I run for. Cause there's no way back, and they're all I have. Am I so lost?
Okay.
I'd give everything, but I'll never.
Mecca's guides.
I'll close my eyes. Cause the world outside is going under.
And keep an eye out for some enemies here, and if we just basically follow the path all the way to the end and visit the last room, you should be able to find Officer Pruitt Matos's collectible named Laundry inside of the office in the back. Another.
Well, I got that one.
Another one that will be harvested. Now, as a reference point, I'm back in the laundry room where we just came from, and instead of going to the right-hand side to an optional path, we're going to go to the left-hand side, which is the main story path. Here, you can head on down the stairs, continue past the intersection, take a right-hand turn, and head inside of the workshop by using your shiv to cut open the box. Once inside, if I'm not mistaken, they're just used, and then you basically just want to follow this path. Inside of these blue hallways, you'll start by doing a corkscrew kind of downwards and to the right. You'll then end up at a ledge where you have to jump down. After you jump down, to turn left. Here you'll notice a small crack that we can squeeze through, and then you'll enter in the first of two secret rooms, and here you'll find a collectible. Additionally, we'll unlock an achievement or trophy for finding both of the secret rooms in the game.
I guess I missed another
secret room.
Yeah, I think I missed another secret room then.
A little bit later on, we can find our second secret room. If you do this and you got secret room number one, you're about to get an achievement or trophy for doing that. But you'll climb up this mandatory ladder as a part of the main storyline. The game wants you to go to the right-hand side to the power reactor. Instead, walk directly in front of you, and you'll be able to shimmy through this crack in the wall.
I didn't go through the crack for something like
20 seconds. Then you'll want to just keep pushing forward through this kind of dark and tight hallway. You'll eventually have to crouch under some rocks, down a hole, find a little ramp that'll take you even deeper, and watch out for enemies at all of these points. Most of the enemies do show up at the end, and they're pretty strong, so you may want to have something like a shotgun ready, like the riot gun or the skunk gun. I found both of them pretty useful throughout the game. And as you come through these hallways, you'll squeak on through. I believe two enemies will spawn at the beginning and one enemy at the end. So watch out, they're going to basically just jump out of the walls. If you want to save ammo, you can by using your security baton, but I found it to be quite difficult as there's not a lot of room to move down here to get dodges going. Also, you may want to work on 5 perfect dodges to get that achievement or trophy out of the way. But at the end of the hallway, you'll notice that there's a secret room kind of in front of you, and all you need to do is go to the right-hand side.
I can't believe I saw that crack, but I go the other way first. That's the thing, you never know which way is gonna be the right way, and then you get knocked out of the... Oh, I remember the crack for the second secret room. I just go the other way first. Oh. I don't think I have that save anyway. So I don't think I have that save anyway. Again, I don't exactly think this is a bad game, but I would say $40 is too expensive. It would be more in line with $30 games in terms of content and what it has to offer, because literally the enemies, you have three types of enemies basically. The ones with projectile where you press left or right to strafe it. The enemy that rush you and then do left-right punches, so you press left and right to dodge. You don't even need to time it. And the third type of enemy is the one that grabs you, so you need to spam E. That's three types of enemy. That's three types of ways to deal with it. All the way till the end. So the entire game has three types of enemy, and that's it. So the combat gets extremely repetitive, and it is made for console, and it has the auto targeting on the enemies. So when you have multiple enemies, the entire combat system just doesn't work anymore, because it will auto target, the game will auto target one enemy and thinks that, oh, you're dealing with this enemy, and then the other enemy will hit you from the side or behind. And many of the enemy have that grab that they instantly throw you to the other direction. And also every time you dodge, it mess up your aim massively every time you dodges. I never get used to it, even all the way till the end. I never get used to it. Every time I dodges, it just throws off my aim so much. So I already have bad aim, and when the game throws off my aim even further, then I just hate using the gun, really. And then you just, basically you just hold left or right and wait until the enemy misses, because as long as you're holding left or right, the enemy will miss. The only thing to look over, the only time the enemy gets you is when maybe except the two head. I don't understand why the two head sometimes you just cannot dodge for some reason. Sometimes when I'm holding the button, you just cannot dodge the two head for some reason. But every other enemy, I only get hit when, well, I mean, sometimes I just didn't press the button, or I got greedy. I think they're gonna do two hits, turns out they do three, or when I think they're gonna do one hit and they do two hits. That's the only time you get hit. And if you have enough patience and left, right, left, right, left, right, then yeah, because you don't need to time it, so it just get extremely, extremely, extremely repetitive. So, and you don't even need to think about the positioning, because as long as you're holding left or right, they're not gonna hit you. So yeah. And yeah, I already talked about the things that doesn't make sense in the game. Like when you randomly have a meat grinder in the middle of the habitat for no good reason. And the meat grinder is not for meat grinding. The meat grinder is, if you throw a body in, the meat grinder is gonna spill out the blood like a fountain. So why is that thing even there? It doesn't make sense in universe. Also the generators and the fans have no protective casing for their spinning compartments, so it makes zero sense for them to just be exposed with the spinning parts. So that is like industrial accidents waiting to happen every single day people work there. Why the hell would the fan have no protective casing and just installed on the side of the wall? Yeah, this thing just doesn't make sense at all. And the story is like okay, it's just generic as hell. The story is really generic as hell, and scary. I mean, if you look at it at isolation, this game is a good horror game, but because we already played three Dead Space game, and this game is advertised as a Dead Space successor, and a Dead Space developers and stuff, there are a lot of players that comes from the Dead Space, and they went after they play three Dead Space games. Like, none of this is gonna really scare them, because it's just in the Dead Space. The tricks are all in Dead Space. So after they play three games of Dead Space, using the same trick on them is like, you know, like the ending. Like, it's just Nicole. It is exactly like Dead Space 1. Oh, you are, yeah, after the final dialogue, and suddenly the jump scare is like, When I saw something swimming in the water, I really thought we are gonna get a new enemy type, but no. The thing swimming in water is never shown to us. There's just nothing there. And then the invisible enemy is like, it is supposed to be scary, but I don't think they go invisible enough. They're not sneaky enough. And again, if you hold left or right, they're gonna jump at you and miss anyway. So it just failed to live up to the horror thing. I guess if you never played Dead Space, then this will be a pretty good horror game, but if you come from 3 Dead Space game, it's like every trick they use is from Dead Space. So there's nothing new there. Like half of the time I even know they're gonna jump at you. Like the enemies playing dead, like half of the time I know exactly that has to be the one that's alive, like the snowfield with all the statue thing. You know one of them or more multiple of them, the snow statues in the snowfield, you know some of them is gonna be the real zombies, so that's not gonna be scaring you. It would work better, I would say, if the second or the third statue is the real one. That may be able to scare you better, but after you, I think the first time you have that is like in the bathroom thing or the locker room thing, where you run into 5 thick statues and then you know one of them or more of them is gonna be a real zombie, so yeah. So most of the time the enemy is gonna wake up or break through the wall is like fairly predictable, because again, coming from Dead Space game, when they show you a guy behind the glass, you know they're gonna break the glass. So it's like, yeah, again, it's not a bad game, but I think it's like slightly overpriced for what it has to offer. I would say $30 is more reasonable for the repetitive gameplay, and we used Dead Space horror. The guns are pretty decent, but maybe I just play on the highest difficulty, but even in Dead Space and the highest difficulty you still have enough ammo. But in Callisto Protocol, if you play highest difficulty, you're just not gonna have enough ammo, so most of the time you're still dodge and then you swing your baton anyway. So, and if there's only one enemy, it doesn't matter how much they mutate, because you can easily dodge them and then baton them until they die. But again, the only way the game can trick you is that sometimes they do one hit, sometimes they do two hits, sometimes they do 4 hits, 3 hits. That's the only way they trick you. You think they stop attacking, so you swing, but you ended up trading hits. That's the only thing the only way the game really damages you. And then I'm just a super duper hoarder, so I just don't like randomly taking damage, so I just keep reloading. And the checkpoint is plentiful if you only care about the main story, then the checkpoints are really plentiful, so it will not be more than like 3 to 5 minutes of progress. But if you want to go to the sideways places to loot stuff, then suddenly the checkpoints become a huge issue, because the checkpoint can cause some item to randomly disappear. Sometimes the checkpoint causes the item to appear, like the zombie die, you storm the body, no item is dropped. But when you load the checkpoint, suddenly there's an item there. Also, like if they go to another room and then come back, the broken glasses will be there again. The broken glass will respawn, will regenerate, the boxes will move, the dead body. Yeah, basically, after you deload and reload the room, it resets to the original form. So even the body get dragged in the vent is reset. So you see the body get dragged even after you kill the enemy, but you come back to the room. So the trigger just triggers again, and because the game deload that room. So when you come back to the room and go through the same vent again, the trigger happens again and you see the body get dragged again. So there's a lot of little things that is not polished. Speaking of small thing that not polished, like you can break the enemy's arm, and then the death scene will still play out like he has an arm. Like a death scene where he pulls on your mouth, one hand pulls upwards and one hand pulls downwards, and then your face just come off. But if the monster is missing a hand, that scene still plays out, so your face just randomly explode because the enemy is missing a hand. So there's a lot of these little places that is not polished, like when you walk up and downstairs, you would do randomly fall a small distance because the polish is not perfect. So it doesn't happen in Dead Space like at all. But in this game, there's a lot of places you go up and down, you just randomly fall a little to the next platform. So yeah, there's a lot of unpolished places that you can notice. So again, I must emphasize, I don't think this is a bad game. I just think it's slightly overpriced for what is it has to offer and what it is hyped up for. So yeah. Do we even have a save over there? Aftermath. Follow the web type. Wait, where is the... Which chapter is this? I want to see if I can find this. I still have a save for the second secret room. When is this?
A little bit later on, we can find our second secret room.
Shun-Yi.
But you'll climb up this mandatory ladder as a part of the main storyline.
It never tells you what's happening when he keep scratching his health bar too. It never said anything about it. Either. Okay. Oh, photo mode. Yeah, okay. I don't think we can. And I don't really want to spend too much time anymore. Oh, it's here. Yeah, this is... Yeah, below is the... Yeah, I think it's the sage guy. Okay. So... Yeah, I should have more menu save. So... Yeah, this is like entire day. Entire day's progress. That's in between. How close am I? If I can get there like in like half an hour, then maybe I won't. Oh, I forgot to check. It's, I'm dumb. How close am I to the next one? Oh yeah, this is the one that... Yeah, when the elevator takes unusually long to come down, you know they're gonna hide something in there. It's like... Yeah, there's just no way. What? I did? Okay, whatever. So, exactly how close am I? Here. Wait, how close am I? Yeah, I think... So, okay. That's pretty far away. No way. Okay, exactly... Did I exactly miss one? So all of that... Yeah, Yankee Sage. Yeah, it's the same one, I think. Yeah, this one is glitch. I think this one is glitch. Habitat. 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 Habitat collectibles. Why the fuck is this lagging so much? Oh my god. I don't know why the fuck it lags so much. Okay. James Weiss, and then Kyle, Sergeant Bill Peckle. Bug warning, make a manual save before picking it up. This collectible is long to not register in the data file menu. Oh, okay. Yeah, it unregistered it. Yeah. So I got this, but it didn't register. So the only one I miss is from a Sienic Sage. Okay. Yeah, next stage. Oh well. Set safe. Secret room 2. Okay, let's see the second second secret room. Mm-hmm. Really? Why does it become so big? Okay, let's see. This is Yeah, I didn't go through the gap. So this is the first secret room I got that. Oh, come on. What? Yeah, this gap. I go to the right side, so. Oh well. Okay. Well, I mean, if the only one I miss is the glitch one, that would be feel a lot bad, a lot worse. But now that I miss two, then yeah. Well, I mean, I actually only miss one, and one more is glitch. The glitch is not as bad because I miss another one anyway. So. Okay. I missed this one and then I lose another one thanks to a glitch, so. Yeah, the eggs, like the little things, like the little things I talk about. The eggs, you storm all the eggs, and when you come back all the eggs respawn, so. Also if they make a secret room here, how the hell do they get in to the secret room? How does it even work? I think this is literally the only place I haven't been to in the game. I loot everything in the game, I think. Or I should say I loot every room in the game. Yeah. How? If they build a secret room here, how the fuck do they? How the fuck do they get in and out? How the fuck do they get in and out? If they build a secret room here. Another thing about not making sense, you know? And another thing that doesn't make sense. If they make the secret room here, how the fuck do they get in and out? I want to hear the log. Please tell me you play the log too. Please tell me you play the log too.
Nice.
Play the log, please. Yeah, it's this guy. Okay, so they want to dig deeper to find the source. Okay. They want to go deeper to find the source. So that's it. What are the other achievements I didn't get? So, in striking distance. Kill an enemy via GLP and a melee combo. Ah. Okay, so how exactly do you do that? The final blow has to be from you pulling the enemy and meleeing it. Wait, you can melee it? Oh. Oh, okay. Okay, we can do that. Which save do we have an enemy? Tower. Go through medical facility. Talk to Dr. Mona. Ah, oh, these saves are pretty annoying though. Do I have the grip here? It should be, you get it pretty early, right? Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, you have this. What? How do you melee? How do you melee? How the fuck do you melee? How do you do pull smack? What the fuck? LT plus A, fuck LT plus A, what the fuck is LT plus A? Are you serious? Can you just... It doesn't... God. What is A? A is select. Select? What even is select? A. Which button is fucking A? Is it space? Oh, maybe it's space. Why is it so slow? It's not space. It's not space. What the fuck? How do you melee them? How do you melee them? I don't understand. How the fuck? Oh my God. What is the button for? Oh, I hate these controllers. I hate the controller inputs. Just tell me the melee button, the attack button, the storm button, the shoot button. How about that? Oh, and then the video doesn't play. The Reaper. Harvest and read all implant bots. Oh, okay. I can't get that. Wait. Oh, because I glitched out. It doesn't register. It glitched out and doesn't register. I should be getting Grim Reaper achievement. It just doesn't register. Okay. So striking distance is okay. Yeah, I can't do that unless I play through the game, half the game. But how the fuck do you get that? Oh my God, why is the player cannot play? Pulling ammo converter LT plus A. Out here to melee them. What is out here? Okay, out here is attack, just melee attack. Okay, out here is just that. Okay. That would become... What? What? LT plus A? Releasing them and press... Oh, release them. Okay. Okay. Well, how long till you get that? Okay, we got that. At least we got that. At least we got that. So yeah, the Grim Reaper and yeah, I can't get that. Well, anyway, I guess that's it for the game. I think I said most of my opinion about the game in a credit. So again, slightly disappointed because I have high expectations and game is slightly overpriced, and yeah, that's it. Not a bad game, but if you really just want a horror game to play, just replay Dead Space. So anyway, I think I'm gonna go play some Brotato. So have a nice day, and I will join you in another universe. The next game would probably be Persona, but I would probably play a few days of Brotato first. So yeah, good morning, good night. Stay derpy. See you in another universe. Goodbye.